Philippine Senator Jinggoy Estrada hoping for a reversal of his bribery conviction in the pork barrel scam. Estrada says his legal team is preparing to file a motion for reconsideration before the anti-graft court. If denied, they plan to elevate the matter before the Supreme Court. For now, Estrada says he will continue to focus on his job as senator.
So there was no political color in my case. I don't think anything will change. I will still continue to become your senator until because nothing is final yet. It is this the decision of the Sandigan Bayan is not final and executory. So I will continue serving as senator until my term ends.
Last week, Estrada was acquitted on plunder charges, but he was convicted of bribery and indirect bribery in the multi-billion peso pork barrel scam. Philippine House lawmakers eyeing to pass the remaining four priority measures of the Marcos administration as the chamber resumes its session today, Monday. House Speaker Martin Romualdez said the bill aimed to promote a national defense industry is up for third and final reading. Meanwhile, the other three priority bills include the Electric Power Industry Reform Act, as well as the Budget Modernization Bill and National Defense Act. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. already signed into law 11 Legislative Executive Development Advisory Council or LEDAC bills, including the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund. President Marcos drawing flak for using the presidential helicopter to attend a concert by British rock band Coldplay in Bulacan. Opposition lawmaker Arlene Brosas called the president's move insensitive and out of touch. Kabataan Party List Representative Raul Manuel also slammed Marcos, pointing out he used a helicopter to attend a concert while the public is being affected by the ongoing chief knee face-out. The presidential security group, meanwhile, defended Marcos, saying it was needed to ensure the safety of the president. The Philippine Arena saw some 40,000 concert-goers during Friday's event. The clock is ticking for thousands of jeepney drivers who have yet to consolidate under the PUV modernization program. Transport officials are set to apprehend and tag unconsolidated jeepneys by February 1st. The drivers and operators now planning to appeal to government to allow them to continue plying their routes.
Ang tingin natin ay hindi natin alam kung saan kinuha ng LTPRB. Halimbawa, yung binabanggit yung dalawang mayor na ruta, yung Cubawa, Irud, Espanya. Anong ilalagay nila sa kagyat ng pagdating ng February? Paano sasaluhin yung mga mararaming mga pasahero? Ang Cubawa, Irud ay halos sa anim na ruta. Paano nila sasaluhin yung mga pasahero dyan?
Aking instructions sa aking mga nasasabihan sa pasang masa, sa mga co-ops at korporasyon namin dinayo, ay tatanggapin po namin sila sa aming grupo para hindi sila mawalan ng hanap buhay at matulungan ng kanilang pamilya.
The LTFRB earlier assured commuters there will be no transportation crisis. Local oil prices going up once again this week. Gasoline prices will see the biggest jump of a peso and 30 centavos per liter, while diesel prices will have an increase of 95 centavos. The cost of kerosene, though, will see no movement. The Philippine Energy Department cites the escalation of tensions in the Middle East, as well as growing global oil demand, as driving factors for the spikes in prices. Another incident of harassment by China in Philippine waters. The Philippine Coast Guard confirms Filipino fishermen collecting seashells near Bajo de Masinloc in the West Philippine Sea were driven away by the Chinese Coast Guard last January 12th. The PCG said the fishermen were prevented from leaving unless they returned the shells they had gathered. The PCG admits the latest incident proves China now has full control of Bajo de Masinloc.
Right after the Scarborough Shoal standoff, we totally lost control of Bajo de Masinloc. Since 2012 until now, it passing through three presidential administrations from the time President Aquino, President Duterte, now President Bongbong Marcos. It is already an open book that the Chinese Coast Guard has a complete control of Bajo de Masinloc.
Despite this, the PCG asserts government is doing its best to counter Beijing's maritime aggression.
It's not true that we have just allowed the Chinese to take control of it. Under this administration, At the same time that they are deploying their vessels, the Philippine government is also deploying our government vessels. Based on our experience and engagement with the Filipino fishermen while the Chinese Coast Guard are there, they are always thankful that the Philippine Coast Guard or BFAR vessel is in Bajo de Masinloc, because they even reported to us that if we are there, then the Chinese Coast Guard will not board their vessel, will not get their catches, or will not even bother them. No, the Chinese Coast Guard will just primarily focus their attention on the Philippine Coast Guard and the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources vessel. Unfortunately, there was really a lapse on the part that there is no BFAR that was there to cover the absence of the Philippine Coast Guard vessel. But I think this will already be operationalized in the next coming months, considering that since we started this transparency and maintaining our presence in the West Philippine Sea.
The provinces of Davao de Oro and Davao del Norte under a state of calamity due to the flash floods and landslides there. The number of affected families now at 77,000. Hundreds of residents of a landslide-prone area remain in evacuation centers. The local government, meanwhile, says they have allotted a housing program for the residents. Vice President Sara Duterte, meanwhile, stressed the importance of preemptive evacuations as she visited the municipality of Moncayo.
Sundin nila kung ano yung instructions ng local disaster risk reduction and management response teams nila kung nasaan yung mga evacuation centers nila. Dapat meron silang mapping ng mga areas na likely bumabaha at nagla-landslide.